Hello, I'm Robin Whalley. Welcome to Lenscraft and another Affinity Photo tutorial. In today's video, we're going to be looking at exporting your edited photos, and we're going to take a deep dive into some of the amazing features of the export persona. Once you've finished editing a photo, you need to export it to share it with others. Start by selecting File and then Export from the menu. This displays the Export dialog. Along the top of the dialog, you can see common file types supported by Affinity Photo. As photographers, it's likely we'll be interested in only a few of these. Let's take a look at the JPEG, TIFF and PSD formats. When we select the JPEG format, we can see options controlling the file creation. First, we can set the size of the file in pixels. For this example, I'm setting the width to 1500 pixels. When I press the Enter key, you'll see the height automatically adjusts to maintain the image ratio. That's because the image ratio has been locked by this padlock icon. When the image is resized, it's resampled using one of the routines in the Resample drop-down list. The default's bilinear, which is good for most things. If though you're making a significant enlargement of an image, you may want to experiment with some of the others. If you click the padlock icon, you see it open. This allows you to set the width and height independently of each other. Next, we can set the quality of the image using the quality slider or the preset dropdown. The quality of the image also affects its file size, which you can see down here. If we choose the best quality JPEG, we can see the slider for quality goes to 100 and the file size is almost 800 kilobytes. If we change the preset now to the lowest quality, the slider's set at 10 and the file size is just under 80 kilobytes. That's almost a tenfold reduction in image size. Let's now look at the TIFF file options and the settings we have available. This time in the presets, we have a choice between the two different supported bit depths. We can choose to create either an 8-bit or a 16-bit image file. We can also choose if the image is going to be in the RGB, grayscale, CMYK or LAB format. Typically for photographs, we're going to be selecting TIFF RGB 16-bit. You also have the option to save affinity layers in the TIFF file as TIFF files support layers. The final format we might use is the PSD format. Here we don't have many options other than the three presets. If we click the More button at the bottom of the screen, it opens a preset editor. We can use this with any of the file formats to create a new preset. By selecting an existing preset, we can see all its settings. If we then change the settings, you'll notice the preset name disappears. You can then use the Manage Preset button to create a new preset. If we now close this and cancel the dialog, we can go back into it and the new preset we've created will be available. Finally, we can press Export to export the image to our hard drive. it's no time to take a closer look at the export persona. Before we open the export persona though, I'm going to add some text to this image. I'm going to do this using the artistic text tool. I'm also going to add a drop shadow effect to the text. This isn't for any other reason other than I like the drop shadows, and you might not have seen it before. Now, I'm going to switch to the export persona by clicking the icon at the top left of the screen. Over on the right side of the screen, we can still see our layers. The icons to the right of each layer allow us to hide the individual layers in the image. We can also turn off individual layers when we export the image using the icon to the left of this. Above this, we can select presets for our export. You should recognize this from the earlier part of the video. Now for a really useful feature, which is the slice tool over on the left. You can use the slice tool to select areas of your image. All you need to do is click and drag. After you've created a slice, you can resize it by clicking and dragging the edges or corners. I'm now going to create a second slice of the same image. On the right of the screen, you can see the slice panel, which shows the original image and the two slices we've created. I can rename each of the slices to something more meaningful. To the far right of each of the slices, we have an export icon. Click this and you export that slice to an image file. The tick box to the left of this allows you to include or exclude slices when making a bulk export. There's also other options we can configure for each slice. By expanding the slice, we can set the scaling for the image as well as the format. The first image will be saved using the dimensions set. We can then add another version of the image with different scaling. In this second image, we'll set the image to be 100 pixels wide. Now when we export this slice, both of these images are created. This can be quite a useful feature if you want to create different versions of your photos. I hope you found this tour of the Affinity Photos export options useful. If you have, please click the like button below and don't forget to share the video. I'm Robin Whalley, you've been watching Lenscraft, I'll see you next week for another video.